Hi, my name is Steve Koza. I'm a consulting scientist here at Waters, and I've been with Waters for 10 years. My principal role at Waters is really developing applications for the separations of biopharmaceutical products. Prior to joining Waters, my experience in the development of the separations for protein biopharmaceuticals has really impressed upon me the importance of having columns that are reproducible, having columns that have good lifetimes, as well as knowing that the supply of that column is going to be available really for the lifetime of the product if necessary. And that's one of the hallmarks, I think, of what Waters does in terms of controlling the manufacturing process. Waters manufactures all of the particles and all of the hardware for our columns. The particles are manufactured in Taunton. The column hardware, the packing of the columns is done in Wexford, and it's all very tightly controlled. And I think that's the one thing from joining Waters that has really impressed me are the folks that are involved in all of that. Perhaps the biggest improvement we've seen in the last 12 years is the advent of sub-2-micron particle sizes for SEC. The advantage of these small particle sizes are that they give us the ability to have much higher throughput SEC analyses, so we can look at a lot more samples under a lot more different conditions for size exclusion chromatography. However, Waters also recognizes the ability to provide scalable particle sizes for these SEC separations. In not all instances is it necessary or even warranted to necessarily run sub-2-micron particles in high throughput. And in some labs, that is necessary to run an HPLC column. So we've also focused on making sure that our HPLC columns perform comparably to our UPLC columns in terms of column secondary interactions, so that we can take methods and easily transfer them from one platform to another platform. Waters has been an innovator in SEC column technology. Waters was the first company to really develop sub-2-micron particles, and we have continually improved upon the reproducibility of our current products by tightening manufacturing specifications and making that product more and more reproducible without changing the overall behavior of the product. However, Waters also recognizes that our current technology doesn't answer every question. So we are continually looking at ways to introduce new and improved products to basically address some of those needs as well. And ultimately, the main goal in all of this will be that, you know, as we produce a new technology, a new SEC column technology that isn't just new, but it's going to be available and be useful to whoever develops an SEC method for a long time.